I'm Abigail.
I'm Seamus.
And you're watching the Wolfpack Weekly News program.
Good morning, everyone, and happy Friday.
We hope all of you have had an amazing week of teaching and learning.
Hey, fellow Wolves. We have finished 1 week of state testing, and we hope all of you did your best on the ELA test.
That's for sure, Seamus. And to ensure that you do your best during testing time, try to get up a little earlier, so you are not rushed to get to school. When you are feeling rushed in the morning, it can stress you out, and you don't want to be stressed out right before you take a test.
Also, whether you like to eat breakfast at home or here at school, make sure you do eat something in the morning. It's hard to concentrate on your test when your stomach is grumbling.
That's right, guys. We want to make sure everyone is rested and fed because we start math testing next week.
Hey, speaking of math testing, in our spotlight today, we have some math classes that have been preparing for state testing.
Let's check it out.
In preparation for state testing, the students in Mr. Bates' math classes recently worked on geometry.
One topic they covered was polyhedrons, or three-dimensional figures.
The task that they were asked to complete was finding the surface area and volume of cones and pyramids.
As you will see in our spotlight, learning math can be fun.
Let's check it out.
Thank you, Mr. Bates, for sharing your math classes with us. It looks like your students are learning a lot and having fun while doing so.
That's right, Alyssa. The students definitely look pretty confident in what they were doing.
Ha, confident. I get it. Hey, speaking of confident people, we talked to some staff this week who seemed pretty confident that they were keeping up with the times and were familiar with our current lingo.
Let's check it out.
What does that mean?
Good morning, fellow wolves, and welcome once again to our game show,
What Does That Mean?
Today we send our crew out to test our teachers and staff to see who knew the meaning of relo, rally, or rel.
Let's see how they did.
So I think what this means is, you know, you shorten stuff, and I think it's people saying for real, you know, like relay, and then they just say rel, like real, for rel, rails, for rails.
It means like relative or bro, I'm pretty sure.
What's up, Rello?
Hey!
Rally, Rello, and Rel. They are all examples of words that start with the letter R.
A Rally is a very small puppy with a large nose. Big eyes.
Rally or Rello? I don't know what it means because I'm old. It means like really, like for real. Like, yeah. But she's already laughing at me, so it doesn't mean that.
Like your Rally would be like, what's up, Rally? Like, like your homie, your friend?
I have no idea.
I really want to do it.
That's kind of like keeping it real. Like keeping it super real, like above reels here. Like I keep it real with my students.
So the true meaning of rally or rel means relative, close friend, or bro.
Congratulations, Miss Garcia and our favorite EDP staff!
Coach D!
You are too cool for school.
Now let's give them a whoa.
One, two, three.
Whoa!
And now,
back to our anchors.
I really enjoyed that segment. It's so funny to hear what the staff at LGA come up with.
I know, right? Most of their answers usually make me laugh.
Well, you know what makes me laugh?
What?
Our wolf pack jokers.
Well then, let's see what kind of jokes they have for us today.
Let's check it out.
It's Tati here.
And I'm just Mo. And we're the Wolfpack
Jokers!
What did the complimentary angle say to the isosceles triangle?
What?
Nice legs!
Where can you buy a ruler that is 3 feet long?
Where?
At a yard sale.
Wow, a yard sale!
What do you call an angle? That is just absolutely adorable.
Thank you, angle!
Why did the inches obey the yard stick? Because he was their ruler!
Oh!
What did the triangle say to the circle?
What?
You're
pointless.
Why did the obtuse triangle get bad grades in school?
Why?
Because it was never.
Thank you, Jokers, for those silly jokes.
That's right, Jokers. Once again, you put a smile on my face.
Hey, Dior, you know what makes me smile?
What?
When we get to recognize our fellow elves for choosing to follow the Wolfpack way.
Well, then let's recognize them right now.
Good idea.
Let's check it out.
Good morning, fellow wolves! It is time for us to choose the recipient to this week's Howl Out.
First, we have Annalise Flores from Miss Mendez for having integrity and being amazing while having a sub.
Second, we have Angel Sotelo from Miss Durflinger for a great improvement in academic responsibility. Keep up the excellent effort in quarter four. I appreciate your dedication to your work.
Nice job, you two, and be sure to see Ms. Birch for your prizes.
Now let's give them a hug.
Hey, let's party, y'all.
Uno,
dos, no tres.
Congratulations.
Congratulations to our Hollow this week. And just as a reminder, don't forget to stop by and see Ms. Birch, your roommate, for your treat.
Hey, while we're on the subject of reminders, before we go, we would like to remind our fellow Wolves of some upcoming things.
Let's check it out!
Hey, 8th graders, ASB is still selling tickets to the Harbor Cruise.
That's right, and we are scheduled to set sail Saturday, June 8th at 4:30 p.m.
So, if you have a GPA of 2.5 or higher and good citizenship grades, get your ticket. The cost is $30.
That's right. Dress to impress. Come aboard. Enjoy food, music, dancing, and great fun with friends. We hope to see you there.
Hey, fellow Wolves, yearbooks are still on sale.
The cost is only $40. And to order, you can go online at yearbooksforever.com or bring cash or check to Chavez in room 28.
Don't miss out on middle school memories. For example, it would be so much fun to go back into your yearbook as an adult and read with your friends how to say.
Hey, Alyssa, let's see what your yearbook says. Dear Alyssa, middle school was so lit. Hit me up over the summer, really?
Or look at old photos of yourself in middle school. Some are sure to make you laugh like these.
Get your yearbook today!
One final reminder, the talent show is coming up on May 29th, Wednesday at 6 p.m. This is a wonderful school annual event.
And even if you are not in the talent show because you do not have talent like mine. Hello! Yo, hello! You should still come out and watch it.
That's right, come out and watch and cheer on our fellow Wolves who are there to share their talent with us.
That's all for this week's broadcast.
Have a great weekend!